So talk to me about someone that wants to adopt or even start to adapt into having a culture of coaching. Where do they start? So somebody that may be watching this says, oh, this sounds fantastic. I just don't know where to start and how do I implement it and who do I have to get buy-in from? So what's the first port of call? What's got to happen there?
Well, there's a number of factors that are going to contribute to that. I guess the first thing is to get a bit of a baseline as to where it is at the moment. And working on some research done a number of years ago, we've developed an instrument that can do a quick analysis of roughly what you think your level of development is. There's four levels: nascent, where nothing much is happening, then tactical, strategic, and embedded. Mm. And we did it at the graduate school, and it was interesting. We asked people what they thought, and we got all four levels. Depends who you ask. Of course, it depends and tended to be related to the hierarchy as to how well people felt we had developed, if you think about that. Mm. But so starting with a bit of an appreciation, and then you have to obviously have people in the organization positioned to have influence. Because you are influencing a system and you've got to look at the system and say, okay, well, if we want to move towards a coaching culture, firstly, is it something we want to do and have a number of people that have experienced and understood coaching sufficiently well to do it? They may have had executive coaching, they may be coaching their teams, they may have done coach training, whatever that might be, and to start the conversations and to start to look for connection points in the organization to start to change it. But it also, it's like any cultural change process. The more people you can engage in it, and interestingly enough, because it's a conversational practice, by engaging people in the conversation, you're demonstrating the power of coaching as a cultural feature of an organization. Yeah. But I found that you do need champions at the top. It may not be the CEO, but preferably it is. Because if you have high success, and we've seen this where we've taken areas of an organization at lower levels and really built up a coaching culture, they then look up and they think, well, actually, this is not a place I want to be. And so then you get an additional challenge that people are actually dissatisfied because they can see the possibilities from coaching, but they can also see that the leaders that they're reporting to are not using it. And that becomes then demotivating and people may even leave the organization.